All right, folks, we are at Best Buy. After all the words we heard, looks like we're going out of business for media. So you might want to jump in and grab what you can before it's all gone. I haven't looked at this one, but doesn't really like captivate me like I have to have it. Let's see. I've already got the other one, so try not to double dip too much. One of the things I really want, that's a maybe, because we just got some other stuff in from Best Buy too, so yeah, that's how it's going to be. It's a matter of time, it's going to be all gone. Buddy, let's see. I'm surprised this is still here. All right, take a look. Ooh. Escape from New York. $23. That's a good deal. If they had Escape from LA, that'd be even better. You get both at the same time. Don't buy that version of Violent Night. There's one on Amazon UK that actually has a freaking awesome collector set. And see, that's crazy. Fog, there's X. I actually need this one to finish up part of my set, Halloween set. Last of Us, Blu-ray. Ooh. If they had a 4K, that'd be even better. Yeah. Alright, let's look at the main stuff. Let's see what we got today. Is everything going to be on sale eventually? See, they got the Next Generation for $65. Kind of waiting to see if they're going to do a combination with it. So you got Avatar. That'll go good, it's a creator here. I saw somebody posting, this is what killed Best Buy. I think what killed it was just being able to sell. Yeah, 1 through 4. Halloween Ends. That looks so bad. So I'm glad I went with the UK one. Come on now. That's just bad. This looks good though. But I just got the box set in from GeoCanal. So I'm trying to be good. Trying not to double dip as much as possible. You know, but we're also here too to pick up something. So, they got some that I've not seen anywhere yet. That was on sale. So I was like, let me jump in that. Living with Chucky. Another great documentary. Okay. We're about done here. They don't have a whole lot more. That's the way it's going. So let's see. We got any toys still. We got a couple. We got a Hogan, Rock, He-Man, some dinos. Holy crap, Goku Black? Never thought I'd see the day. Batman. Okay. Ooh. The red version. I got the black versions. So I'm good with that one. Long Kills. Ash Ronin. Yeah. I hear him. Armored. Just got that in from my boy, Carl. Thank you, Carl. Okay. I think that's it. All right, I'll show you guys later what we got from here picked up. All right. All right, we at Walmart. Let's see what they got today. Just same old ones. We got Mirage, Zamata, Toxitron, Blitzwing. The Fallen still here. Crosscut. That's a shrapnel wave. Take a look. Cloud Cover. Rampage. Armada. Animated. Now let's see. Same old stuff up top too. They're loving the turtles, I'll tell you that. Especially old movie ones. Alright, let's look at some legends. Let's see. Kingpin. Same old waves. Nothing new. Not even the new X-Men wave. Mr. Freeze. Got the Flash. But nothing to cry home about. That's how it goes sometimes. Well, I mean, they got Ezra. There you go. Ahsoka. If you don't have an Ahsoka by now, you got bigger issues. They've had that up for a while. Danhausen. Saw him on the drive-in. Yeah, but nothing. Darby. Roman. Let's see. Yeah, a whole lot of nothing. That's how it goes lately. Power Rangers, Joes, same old. I mean, we haven't got new stuff in a while. All right, that's going to be it for Walmart, folks. Talk to y'all later. All right. All right, we are at Ross. Let's see what they got. Everybody else has been getting lucky finding stuff. $7.99. Not too bad. Just not seeing a whole lot. Let's see. I might have missed it. $8.99. Not too shabby. But let's see. I'm gonna keep looking. Nope. See ya. Got a little bit. Stalker. Let's see. Actually, I do need this one. So we got one. Let's see. And then the Joker. Not too shabby. It's worth at least a shot. All right. Hello, my people. It is your redneck from Texas, Nate. And guess what? We are on a toy hunt, and we found some goodies. We found ourselves B127. This is, of course, from the Studio Series one. We found us at Ross for that great little price right there, $7.99. So definitely not going to pass up on that, especially when they're $23 originally. Plus tax, we're going to get it. As you guys know, I went to Best Buy first, and I had to pick up something. I had to pick up my Phantom of the Opera. This, of course, is from Universal Monsters to go with my set right here. Definitely always enjoy these ones. So now I'm going to be looking out for a Creature from the Black Lagoon, the color version and the black and white one. Now, we have got some stuff in as well. So, let's further ado. We had some stuff that came in. We've just been opening these up. So, but we do have some stuff to show y'all, too. This is, of course, Cemetery by the Gate, or House by the Cemetery. This is, of course, the third part of the Gates of Hell trilogy. And this is the original art cover. I always get these when I buy them. That comes from Arrow Direct. Always do. Because I enjoy those versions. We also got in Prey. This, of course, I was so excited to get in. This is only at Best Buy. So we got lucky and got this one in. It's pretty much I've only seen it here. It wasn't at Best Buy the last time I looked at it either. Also, we got in The Mist. Now, this is a cool one because the way this works, you got this in the back. So it kind of folds out like so. And what's cool is it's old school. You get the regular, you got the, and then there's a black and white version. And then they did that for both the Ultra, and they did that for the Blu-ray. So So it's a four disc set. So this is definitely worth it. I highly recommend everybody to pick this one up. Okay, put that back in there. And it was like $25, I think. So that's a good deal. Four disc collector's edition? Oh yeah. Then of course we had to get, you know, the steelbook of Transformers Rise of the Beast. You know me, even if the movies aren't that great, I'm still a media collector, and I am a huge Transformers collector, so still had to pick this one up. So we got this one in. And then from Amazon UK, we got the Wicker Man box set from Studio Canal. And this is a phenomenal set, so let me just show you. It's like magnetized, so it's got like a little box here. And then you get all kinds of goodies. You get like a little flyer. You get a poster. You get another poster. Some art cards. You get a collector's booklet. You get a digipack. And they still, and this was still available last I saw. But what you get is everything. You get the soundtrack, the Blu-rays, the Ultra HDs. And the cool part is this is the final cut, the director's cut, the theatrical cut. So you're getting everything, Wicker Man. And you get the soundtrack. Come on now. See, that's why I used to love like Blue Underground and even Severin and Synapse and them all do that. Boutique labels will do stuff like that for you. And what I've noticed overseas, Studio Canal and a couple of others, they do some great stuff like that. So we need to get on the ball, folks. Get on the ball, Americans. Okay. All right. That being said, we got one of the coolest sets of the year. And that is the Paramount Scares collection. This is five movies from multi-generations that they give you. It also comes with, I'm going to show you. I'll show you what's inside. You get your own Fangoria magazine. You got some stickers. But behind the stickers is the actual pen. Okay, you get specialized slip covers for these movies. This first one being Rosemary's Baby. And these are all 4Ks and Blu-rays. So you get the best of both worlds. Just in case. Okay. You get Smile. I've actually needed to get this and haven't picked this up yet, so I'm glad I waited. You get the 30th anniversary 4K of the original Pet Sematary. That is Bella. You get Sweeney Todd, which this was actually was the surprise one that nobody knew if they were going to get it or not. And this is actually one of my favorites that I've watched recently. And that is Crawl by the great Sam Raimi. So, definitely. If you've not seen Crawl, go pick it up. So, yeah, it's sort of, like I said, it's a mixture of different kinds of horror. That way you can get a different view. Like, I would imagine with Paramount's library that we're going to see a lot more down the pipe to go with it. So, that's just a couple of things we got in. All right. Now, put that away. We got a couple things in the mail too, so I wanted to share these and hold off. Let's see. All right, first up from Amazon. Let's see what we got. Oh yes, the Universal Essentials Collection. We have Schindler's List. Okay, this is the 4K Blu-ray. This is their answer to Arrow. If you see that, it looks just like an Arrow box. And I'm okay with that, because if they learn from Arrow and build it the same way, I'm good with it. Yeah, this has a 30-page book. It's got some cards. And it's actually got a cell, a film cell as well. So, good on you. Good on you, folks. They're learning. They're learning. All right. Fragile. From Enjoy the Tombs. We've not bought from them in a long time because they don't really have a whole lot of stuff that we get. Listen to a whole lot. But they do put some things out occasionally that we're like, hey, I want to get that one. All right. And I told them to go on and open this one, because here's the thing, sometimes you will get splits in things. So I asked them, I said, go on and open it. And then that's what they did. And it is the Cybertron Spree Ravage. This is the new, their actual first one, because their first album on their own. Because the last one they had was actually just them singing songs, right? But this one is actually theirs. Yeah, see? We got a split here, which is what happens sometimes. And it's the Ravage color. I don't know how good it comes out. That looks pretty good. So yeah, we got this one. They are a blast to see. If you ever get a chance to see them in person, go watch the Cybertron Spree. They're, like I said, they're awesome people. Alright. Put you back here. Yeah. Okay. Alright. And then we have two big boxes. This one, we're going to do this one last. This one is my Kickstarter, which is very heavy. It says, I don't even say the weight, but it is heavy. I'm excited for it, because I waited, I think, almost a year for this one. But that wait is worth it, folks. Okay. Okay. Mm. Because of the goodness that's inside. Okay. So we got our Witchblade coin. Just want to take it out of here so we can show it. Okay. we got our lanyard, which is very nice. They've actually really, it's really made well. Okay. We got Witchblade Kickstarter Volume 1. I'm so glad they do it this way. Oh, there's something extra. It's like a little topper. And volume 3. The reason why this one is open, because it comes with a signed sketch book plate by Mark Sylvester. So, that is awesome. I love little things like that. Okay. And then last but not least, we have the goodies box. A goodies bag, we'll say. We got the Steven Sedgwick preview for Witchblade number 1 coming out. So, I will probably read it. I was a huge Witchblade fan. I love reading that series. We got a sticker, and then we've got a metallic bookmark, and then we got some prints, some vestry, Francis J. Manapul. That is awesome. Michael Turner and Nei Rufino. D-Tron. And then Ching. So, that is our Kickstarter we got, which is awesome. Okay. Let's put these back in the bag so we don't destroy them. Because we're going to take a better look at those later on our own time. But just kind of wanted to show you guys what we got in. Okay. Put all this in here. Okay. And our sticker. All right. Now we are down to the last box from our boys at Media Psychos. Thank you, John. Let's see what's in Bad Mama Jamma. I didn't even know he was sending me anything. Making sure nothing else in the box. Never know with my boys. Always some goodies in there. what this is. Okay. Yeah. I waited on these for a little while. So I wasn't in a rush to get them. Whatever he could do it. All right, we're gonna pause for a second and I'll be right back. All right, we got them all done. I don't know if you can see that little sticker, but it's hard to see. But we got, oh, this will help you. The green mile. And it's such a low number. It's hard to hold it. Number 10 out of 138. I think that's the lowest I've got so far. This is what I love about UHD Club. They take such care when they build and they're giving you something. They want to make sure it's like brand new to you. Because the first one I got was here we go, a green mile from UHD Club. It's got the little sticker there too. And so what I always do is I take the sticker and I put it right on the book. That's what I do. That way I don't lose it. But yeah, here we go, UHD Club. We will do a review of these, so don't worry, they're coming, because these are amazing releases, and I like showing them off. That's what we do, because good folks at Media Cycles always take care of Nate, so let's do a review for them. It's easy, easy peasy lemon squeezy. Okay, that's the first one. The second one, another little sticker. We got the Shawshank Redemption. Not as low as the other one, but still. 145 out of 300, so still under the 150 range. Okay. Again, like I said, they take care of stuff. They want to make sure. Mighty Purdy. Shawshank Redemption. Alright. That is it, folks. I hope you guys enjoyed the hunt and the haul and everything that we got in the mail. Stay tuned, folks. We got a lot more coming. This has been your Redneck from Texas, Nate. Have a good one, and I'll see you on the next one. All right, all right, all right.